Good morning, everyone. So once again, welcome you all for our ICSI centralized classes. Now we're going to discuss the part of CSR, everyone, as we started introduction yesterday's. Now moving ahead for the further discussions, everyone. As we know, what is the purpose of CSR? So as a routine check, we will within 5 minutes revise whatever we have discussed in the last class, everyone. So it's a CSR, corporate social responsibility, as we discussed. Being a corporate, we have some responsibility towards society, everyone, and we have to do our responsibility. Fine. We have to perform our duties and obligations towards our responsibility, everyone. So that's why the introduction says the concept of business being accountable for how it manages the impact of its processes on stakeholder. So here we are taking care of the stakeholders. The term stakeholders is broader than shareholders, everyone. The term stakeholder means each and every person having the interest. We should take care of their interest, everyone, whether he is a creditor, debtor, government, customer as well, right? So everyone who are connected with the company will be called as a stakeholder. Now moving ahead, how we will do the business, everyone? The concept says we have to follow legal perspective also. We have to follow the law compliances and ethical business practices. And also, we have to fulfill some obligation towards society because we are using the resources of the society, everyone. Moving ahead, what was the need that we have discussed yesterday? Business uses scarce resources of the society. So, you know, the business should return back. Now, the business should supplement the government's effort, right? Governments alone can't do the changes, right? So, corporates must assign something towards the society, everyone. So, that's why the concept is. Business often adversely affect the environment and society. As we discussed, no business can say that they are not affecting the environment. Fine. So government alone cannot tackle the problem for the inclusive growth, everyone. What is inclusive growth? As we discussed, sabka saath sabka vikas. Each and every sectors, each and every communities of the country must grow. Business cannot succeed in a society which fails. So business is itself running their activities in a society. So he it should be it should take care of the, you know, societies so that they can able to grow. Moving ahead, next, in this slide we have discussed these are the stakeholders and we must consider their interest for the sustainable development, right? Be it customer, be it supplier, environment, communities, and employees. Moving ahead, everyone. Then we discussed the differences between philanthropy and CSR. Philanthropy is a traditional concept where we used to, you know, donate something for a community, right? But we never checked that what donations, I mean, what they are getting from us, whether they are utilizing for the proper purposes or not, or they are wasting that particular money, the resources, etc. But in CSR, everyone, there's an impact assessment, right? An analysis will be there, and a check will be there. By your contribution, is there any changes occurred or not? Is any impact happened or not? So CSR is a broader concept than the philanthropy, as we discussed yesterday. So I am reading the last para only. A CSR program does not only benefit the community, everyone, but it also the businesses in the form of improved morale, increased society, and status as an employer of choice, attracting new businesses and differentiation from the competitors. So these are the advantages that the CSR taught us. This is because the CSR program requires involvement from all the stakeholders, including employees as well as the community. So here we are taking care of all the person who are connected with the company, everyone. So moving ahead, what are the advantages, sir? CSR helps in brand building. CSR helps in product differentiation. CSR helps in business, making strategies, socio-economic development, customer loyalty, financial performance as well. And last but not the least, by which we can able to get capital, right? And access capital from the community. Because when the company contributing to our society, then customer or society, got some, informations that these companies are doing something for the national building. Fine. So moving ahead, product differentiations done by making the, bringing the changes as per the CSR, the customer sometime know the importance of the product. I just took an example, the classmate copy of the ITC. Right, everyone. Moving ahead, now, so this is our, initial part when the, act came into force and the sections implemented, right? But the last para is quite important to understand, that how the company can perform such activities. See, we will today discuss everything about CSR, their compliances part, their obligations part, and the applicability as well. But before going to discuss this, before a discussion of that particular things, I just wanted you to focus in this area. Whenever CSR gets attracted to the company has to perform some activities towards the society. And such activity as per the Schedule 7 of the Act, that is Companies Act. So we'll come into this, but before that, let us discuss these CSR activities through the following methods. That means once it is gets attracted, now you have to perform some obligation contributions. How you'll perform? Number one, directly on its own. You can perform directly on its own. Right. Next, though its own not profit foundation, you can also make a own non-profit foundation setup, just like a Tata has done. Tata Foundations. You can also open your own non-profit foundations setup for doing such activities. So the main companies will contribute their obligation to such own non-profit foundations, and such own non-profit foundations will do some activities, that is as per Schedule 7. Are you through with this, everyone? Very good. Moving ahead, number 3 point, you can also take help from the independent registered non-profit organizations. Independent, that is not your own. But make sure if you are taking the help from such independent organization, It has a track record of 3 years in a similar activities, in a similar related activities, everyone. And number four, collaborating or pooling their resources with other companies, that means two or more company can combine together for doing such an activities. Obviously, whatever the activity the company is going to perform now, it will be as per Schedule 7 of the Companies Act. I guess it is very okay to all of you. Next, let us start the today's class, everyone. So that was the earlier discussions, right? Moving ahead for the today's discussion, everyone. Here we have the list. Where we have the list, everyone. Now, from this point, we are going to class start the class. Schedule 7, which says these are the activities the company must focus upon. Because anything that is not covered under Schedule 7 will not be treated as CSR activity, everyone. So Schedule 7 has a very, very, very important part of the CSR provisions, everyone. So what is the activities, sir? Let us start. Number one, if you are helping for eradicating hunger, poverty, malnutrition, promoting, preventing health care and sanitation, making available safe drinking water to the community, if you are dealing with this, your activity will be considered as a CSR activities, everyone. Right? Number next, promoting educations, including special educations and employment, enhancing vocational skills, especially among children, women, elderly, and differently able, and livelihood enhancement projects, everyone. So, number one, hunger, malnutrition. Number two, promoting educations, including special education, etc. So we have to remember each and every words from this particular Schedule 7, answer is no. You are not a computer to remember everything, right? But at least you must able to write the proper words. Be it eradicating hunger, poverty, malnutrition, that will be sufficient if you are answering like this. Number next, promoting educations, including special education, employment, enhancing vocational skills. And number third, everyone, promoting gender equality. That is the essence of our fundamentals, right? Next, empowering women, setting up homes and hostels for the women orphans, setting up old age homes, everyone. These kind of things, you know, covered under the CSR activities. Make sure if you are performing such this activities that is mentioned in Schedule 7, then such activity will be treated as compliant activities. Otherwise, the whole purpose, you know, the whole money will be wasted because it will not be treated as CSR activities, everyone. I just wanted your attention to draw in the time of COVID, right? The Schedule 7 has been amended very quickly by the government that anyone providing the facility for the taking care of COVID patients, right? Any kind of facilities, right? Then that contribution will be counted as a CSR activities, everyone. Fine, moving ahead. Ensuring environmental sustainability, right? We will discuss today how ecological balances, that means number 4 point is totally, you know, for the environment, you know, protections. Ecological balances, protections of flora and fauna, animal welfare, agroforestry, conservation of natural resources, and maintaining quality of soil, air, and water, as the Isha Foundation is doing now. Isha Foundation, you must have known Isha Foundation. Adi Yogi. Fine. Protections of natural heritage, art, and the culture, including restoration of building, sites of historical places, everyone. It is gaining importance nowadays. Setting up public libraries, promotions and development of traditions, art, handicrafts. That is not impossible to learn each and every words for exam, but at least you should read it by two or three times so that you are able to write few words from here, right? Now moving ahead, measures for the benefit of the armed forces veterans. Oh my God, it's also covered here. War widows, their dependents. So if you're making anything, any activities for them, then it will also be counted as Rule 7 activities, everyone. Training to promote rural sports. Paralympic, as I said yesterday, that Paralympic has not very much benefited from this kind of funds, everyone. And they are doing good results in the Olympic Games. Sports and Olympic sport as well. Moving ahead. Contribution to Prime Minister National Relief Fund. See, if you're not able to make arrangements, if you're not able to make arrangement, you know, everyone, if you're not able to make arrangement for such activities, whatever we have mentioned in the last slides, whatever we have discussed in the slides, then the Schedule 7 says, by simply contributing to this fund, Prime Minister National Relief Fund, you will be treated as a CSR compliant company. You will be treated as a CSR compliant company, everyone. But at the same time, you cannot ask from the PMNR fund in which area this fund has been, you know, utilized. Your money has been utilized, right? Because they will do according to their policy, according to their requirement. Fine. Moving ahead, everyone. Government of Socio-Economic Development, Relief and Welfare, Scheduled Caste, Scheduled Tribes, other backward classes, minorities, and women. These are also here. Contribution of funds provided by technology incubators located within academic institutions which are approved by central government. Just for IITs ka example, le lete hain. IIT is here, covered here. So if you're making any contributions for them, for the academic institutions like IITs, theek hai. Now, rural development projects. If you are working for the rural development project, slum area development, such activity will be covered here, everyone. So what we have discussed, sir, if the companies gets trigger by the figure, come on, if the companies gets trigger by the figure, then the company has to perform some activities, and such activity will be mentioned. As per, you know, such activity will be done as per Schedule 7 of the Companies Act, everyone. Very, very good. I hope you people are enjoying the classes. Moving ahead. So, let us first discuss the applicability. Right? So, these are the figures. If it's trigger, then you have to comply two things. So here the term is used every company. What is every company? Come on. Please speak like this. Wherever you are sitting, with whom you are sitting, right? Please use, chant the word every company. Kya? Every company. That means it may be private company, it may be public company, even Section 8 company as well. Every company, if such company having the turnover 100 crores or more, everyone. So why you are emphasizing the words every? Because of case study, everyone. Because of case study. Right? So, if your company private, but the turnover is 1,000 crore or more, इट्स एप्लीकेबल, इट्स एप्लीकेबल. सीएसआर प्रोविजंस विल अट्रैक्ट. वेरी वेरी गुड. मूविंग अहेड, नेटवर्थ क्राइटेरिया. द नेक्स्ट क्राइटेरिया इज नेटवर्थ, दैट इज 500 करोड़ और मोर. एंड एवरीवन प्लीज मार्क हियर, इट्स द ऑर. दैट मीन्स एनी कंडीशंस, वेदर इट टर्न ओवर और नेटवर्थ और नेट प्रॉफिट ऑफ 5 करोड़ और मोर, इफ ट्रिगर्ड ना, यू हैव टू कंप्लाई द प्रोविजन ऑफ सीएसआर. यू हैव टू कंप्लाई द प्रोविजन ऑफ सीएसआर. आर यू थ्रू विद दिस एवरीवन? सो व्हाट इज द टू थिंग्स सर वी हैव टू परफॉर्म? इफ इट्स गेट्स एप्लीकेबल, यू हैव टू परफॉर्म टू एक्टिविटीज. व्हाट इज द टू एक्टिविटीज सर? नंबर वन, यू हैव टू फॉर्म अ सीएसआर कमिटी. सीएसआर कमिटी एवरीवन, एंड ऑल्सो कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन एट द रेट 2% ऑफ द लास्ट 3 इयर्स एवरेज प्रॉफिट. आर यू थ्रू विद दिस एवरीवन? सो एवरी कंपनी हैविंग सच रिक्वायरमेंट, व्हाट इज द रिक्वायरमेंट? एवरी कंपनी, इफ यू नो इट हैज अ टर्नओवर ऑफ 100 करोड़ और मोर, नेटवर्थ 500 करोड़ और मोर, नेट प्रॉफिट 5 करोड़ और मोर, इन सच केसेस एवरीवन, द कंपनी हैज टू परफॉर्म टू थिंग्स. नंबर वन, इट हैज टू मेक अ सीएसआर कमिटी, एंड कमिटी विल बी फ्रॉम द बोर्ड मेंबर्स ऑफ द कंपनी. एंड नेक्स्ट, इट हैज टू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू एटलीस्ट 2%, 2% कंपल्सरी, 2% फॉर द प्रॉफिट, फ्रॉम द प्रॉफिट दैट इज एवरेज प्रॉफिट फ्रॉम द लास्ट 3 इयर्स. वी विल कम इन टू द कैलकुलेशन, बट दिस आर इंट्रो टू द सीएसआर प्रोविजन. आर यू थ्रू विद दिस एवरीवन? वेरी वेरी गुड. सो लेट अस डिस्कस सम यू नो सम आंसर सो दैट वी विल एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड इन डिटेल, राइट? जस्ट अ सेकेंड. Now, let us discuss in a question answer manner. Number one question, which companies qualify for CSR under the Companies Act 13? A company, everyone, satisfying any of the following criteria. The company is satisfying any of the following criteria. Which criteria? Net worth, turnover, net profit. Net worth, turnover, net profit. Just read it out, everyone. So, a company satisfying any of the following criteria during the immediately preceding financial year. So, whether CSR getting applicable or not, it depends upon immediately preceding financial year. Once again, a company satisfying any of the following criteria during the immediately preceding financial year. Immediately preceding financial year. What is the criteria, sir? We have discussed the criteria. Then, if the figure is triggered, everyone, any of the criteria, then you have to comply two things: contributions and making a committee. Moving ahead, now the question number two: whether a holding or a subsidiary company fulfilling the criteria under Section 135(1) has to comply with the provisions of Section 135, even if the holding or subsidiary company does not fulfill the criteria. Have you got the question, everyone? Whether a holding or a subsidiary company, a subsidiary of a company fulfilling the criteria under Section 135 has to comply the provisions of Section 135 if even if the holding and subsidiary does not fulfill the criteria. Act says no. This is a specific requirement for a specific company. I mean to say, this is a specific requirement to every company. So connection of holding and subsidiary is not, no, is not to be considered here. If your company itself triggers this criteria, then your company will have to comply, otherwise not. So let us understand the answer. No, the compliance and the CSR requirement is specific to each company. A holding or subsidiary of a company is not required to comply with the CSR provisions unless, come on, unless the holding or subsidiary itself fulfill the eligibility criteria. So it's a independent criteria to each and every company. There's no connections for holding and subsidiary. There's no connection that the if the holding gets attracted, then subsidiary will automatically gets attracted. No. Are you through with this, everyone? So whether holding or subsidiary of a company fulfilling the criteria, even if the holding or subsidiary of the company does not fulfill the criteria. Let us take an example. A company is covered under the criteria mentioned under 135. What is the criteria? There are three criteria, everyone. If A is covered, if A is covered, if company B by itself does not satisfy any of the criteria, company B is not required to comply the provision of the act. If A company is covered under the criteria, company B is holding company of A, company B is a holding company of A, so subsidiary gets attracted, but holding is not, then company B of holding company of A, AB company by itself does not satisfy any of the criteria, company B is not required to comply with the provision of section of 38, 135. Are you through with this, everyone? Then the company will not be held, for such 135. Is it okay, all of you? Moving ahead. Now, next. Whether provision of CSR applicable to a Section 8 company? Yes. Because the act itself says every. Are you through with this, everyone? For case study. For case study kind of questions, we must focus on these words. Moving ahead. Number four questions from the applicability part. Whether CSR provisions apply to a company that has not completed the period of 3 financial years? Someone may say, sir, हमारा 3 साल तो हुआ ही नहीं है. So how we can able to know, how we will able to take the 3 years average profit? The act says compulsory 3 years elapse is not required. If you are a latest company, I mean to say, if you're a new company having your 1 or 2 years of enactment, you will have to perform these CSR activities or CSR obligations because the figure is trigger. Yes. If the company has not completed the 3 financial year since its incorporation, but it satisfies any of the criteria 135, the CSR provision, including spending of at least 2% of the average net profit, are also applicable. Are you through with this? We are focusing as per question so that you will able to understand very, very, very well manner, right? Because if something, for understanding something, we need some questions, right? So these are the questions. 3 years has not been lapsed, sir. So how will take the average last 3 years ka profit? Access, don't worry. If it's not done now, but if the figure is triggered now, and you are the just 2 years company, average the such 2 years, right? And make the contributions of 2%. Very, very good. Because CSR applicably says we have to check the previous year's data so that we can able to say it is, you know, trigger or not. Are you through with this, everyone? Very, very good. Let us moving ahead for the next part. Before that, let us discuss the example so that it will be good for the understanding. Now, a company A is incorporated during 1819. Company A. And as per the eligibility criteria, the company is covered under 135. The CSR spending obligations under 135 of a company A would be at least 2% of the average profit. Right, everyone? A company A is incorporated during financial 18-19, and as per the eligibility criteria, the company is covered under the section 135 for year 2021. So company gets incorporated 18-19, but the trigger is figure, I mean figure is triggered under the, you know, year 2021. The spending obligation A would be at least 2% of the average net profit made in 18-19 and 19-20. Okay, everyone. So 18-19 and 19-20 ke profits ko average kar lenge. Now, these are the, you know, the question answer for applicability, everyone. Now moving ahead for the other requirements of CSR. Let me show the PPTs. Fine. So if we have done this, at least 2% of average net profit of the company made during the 3 immediate previous years, but the company has not completed the 3 financial years since its incorporation, during such immediately preceding financial year will be considered all profits to be spent in pursuance of CSR corporate responsibility policy, right? So company is required to make policy, but before that, company has to frame a CSR committee who will be responsible for making policy of the CSR. So what are the requirement to have the, you know, CSR committee? This is the PPT. Moving ahead. CSR committee. If it is a public company having ID, what is ID, sir? Independent director. Section 149, Subsection 3 have the criteria for the independent directors, everyone. We will discuss that class, you know, that topic in the director chapter. But for the time being, What is the independent director, sir? The independent director मतलब the person who are not biased with the such decisions and decisions, who are not connected, who are not related with the promoters or the directors or the KMP of the company. That's why the term independent director. Independent director doesn't means whose date of birth is 15th August. Believe. Fine. Moving ahead. So public company, if the public company having ID, that means public company is required to appoint ID as per section 149. In that case, the CSR committee will constitute or will be composite compositions of or will consist of three directors. Three directors, one of whom shall be an ID. If it is a public company, everyone. If it is a public company, then we can say if ID is there, at least three directors, and out of such three directors, one must be a ID. Okay, fine. If public company not having ID, loss is two directors sufficient. Two directors is sufficient. And the similar provisions for the private company as well, which says two directors is also sufficient to make a committee. To make a committee. Are you through with this? I am going very slow because of these topics have to be carefully understood, because of if we are not able to understand these provisions, then we'll make some mistake while writing. So these are the essential provisions compulsory to understand. So moving ahead, so what we have discussed is CSR committee have to be formulated. CSR committee when the figures get trigger. Number one, public company, for the public company having ID, so we have to take three person as a director, one of whom shall be an independent director. And number next, not having ID, two directors. Private company has the same criteria, two directors, and foreign company, that means foreign company can also be attracted if the figure is gets trigger, everyone. Very, very good. Moving ahead. So foreign company, you must have read the section 380 subsection 1 clause D, which says if a foreign company doing business in India, the foreign company appoint a person who will be a resident of India, one person compulsory, right? So foreign company must formulate a committee by taking such one person along with the other as well, at least two, but out of such two, one such person who was there while the companies gets incorporated, such two person will formulate a committee that is called CSR committee. Let us read it, everyone. The CSR committee of a foreign company shall comprise of at least two persons, of which one person shall be a resident in India as per section. So it is also having two directors, but one for resident. Kaun sa wala resident, sir? Which one, sir? Law says, remember, when such resident person is required as per 381D for the taking registration, for the taking the incorporation of a foreign company in India, that person will be there in the committee. Are you through with this, everyone? Are you through with this? Very, very good. So, foreign company. And another person who shall be nominated by the foreign company. So, one shall be, resident, and one will be, nominated member by a foreign company. By a foreign company. Are you through with this, everyone? I'm just taking a break of 5 minutes. We'll be back shortly for the further discussion, everyone. Welcome back, everyone. Let's so as we discussed, TSR, this is the CSR committee formations, and it's made compulsory when the figures of Section 135. So public company have to be three director as a committee. Make sure one ID. If the ID requirement is there and not having ID, then two director itself complied. Private company, two director, and foreign company, two also. But out of such two, one will be such person who was in the incorporation at inco who was at the time of incorporations as per one as per 331D. Very, very good, everyone. So moving ahead, some question answer series, so they can we will able to understand deeply. Next, fine. What is the composition of CSR committee? We have done this. We will go into the MAT, Institute MAT, don't worry. Listed company. Now, here the listed company. Listed company means three or more directors. We have covered the listed also here, but out of which one shall be independent director? Out of which one shall be independent director? Okay, everyone. Unlisted public company, three or more directors. Same, at least one shall be ID. However, if there is no requirement, two. Private company, two or more directors, no independent directors are required, because private company, don't have a requirement to appoint independent director. Moving ahead, foreign company, one shall be as specified in 380, the person who was there at the time of incorporation of the company. Next, another shall be nominated by the foreign company itself. Moving ahead. Now, if the CSR obligation requirement is not exceeding 50 lakh, as per the contribution, as per the average profit, if the mandatory contribution requirement does not exceeding 50 lakh, everyone, the company for constitution of CSR company is not mandatory. So in such cases, the formulations of committee is not mandatory, everyone. Is not mandatory. Are you through with this? Very, very good. And the function of CSR committee in such shall be done by whom? Discharged by whom? Board of director itself. See, out of such board of directors ही हैं जिनसे हम लोग कमिटी बनाते हैं. Very good, everyone. Right? So the committee is itself formulating from such member of board of directors, from the members of board of directors. Right? So if the obligation does not exceed 50 lakhs, no requirement, no compulsory requirement for making the CSR committee. Company may formulate, but the law says you can discharge the work by the board of director itself. Moving ahead, what are the functions of CSR committee? Now, this is very much important. Why? CSR committee is the committee who will formulate and recommend the CSR policy to the board. They will make a CSR policy, and also, everyone, please remember, CSR policy. CSR policy, will be as per Schedule 7. Right? So we can say CSR policy is based on Schedule 7. What does it mean, a policy? in which the purpose will be mentioned, the activities will be mentioned, right? Now moving in, the CSR committee will recommend the amount of expenditure to be incurred on CSR activities. So CSR committee will recommend what amount is required to be spent. Monitor the CSR policy of the company from time to time. So that's make a difference from the philanthropy, everyone. Here we have to make a committee, and such committee is responsible for the proper contributions, and also such committee will monitor. Such committee will monitor. The CSR policy of the company from time to time. Are you through with this, everyone? Very, very good. Moving ahead, everyone. Now, formulate the recommend to the board on the annual action plan. The CSR committee has to prepare up. What is up? The annual action plan in person CSR policy, which shall include the items rule 5.2 of the CSR policy, rule 14. Everyone. So, what law says? The committee have to prepare up, that is annual action plan. What the company is going to right? So it has to be done. For companies covered under 135(9) are not required to CSR have committee. These functions shall be carried out by the board itself, as we discussed. If the obligations is law is not exceeding 50 lakh, that is less than 50 lakhs, then we can say such formulations of policies, monitoring and formulating recommendation to the board and all will be done by the board itself, the board of director itself. Just a second, everyone. I'm just showing you the app, the glimpses of app of company. App kaisa hota hai? I'll just show you. Just a second. Very, very good. No. I'm taking the example of Asian Paints, everyone. Asian Paints, the top company, the number one company of the paints industry, in the paints industry, everyone. So this is the CSR annual action plan of this company for the year 2022-23. So as we studied, right, as we discussed, that the company has to formulate a AAP, that is called annual action plan, annual action plan. Annual action plan. Now, what does cover the app, sir? Let's discuss. Number A, the list of CSR project. The list of CSR project that is going to be done, that is going to be performed by the committee. So they have segregated the funds by these and these activities. Everyone, I'm just wanting you to focus in these part, the focus area of CSR as per Schedule 7, the focus area of CSR, everyone. Just look this. Just look into this, everyone. Have we discussed as per Schedule 7 promoting education, including special educations. Can you able to connect? Right? And the project name is Education Project, Education Support. And the place of will be, you know, see, the law says now, the company should focus their, you know, nearest area, right, where the company is operating. Matlab, the preference should be given to that local area, right? So here, the Asian company has made us some project for the educational purposes in this place, Tamil Nadu, and reaching extremely vulnerable children. The amount is 20 lakh rupees. Very good. Now, the next work, that is again promotions of educations, right? Everyone. Vocational skills, right? And the same place, the name is Colorful Community Project. Colorful Community Project, everyone. Fine. And spend it. 20 lakh again, but they are about to spend. Next, promoting educations, same work, but the place is different. Supporting the science, right? Lab amount is 10 lakh. The same again, promoting educations. Skill development program. Right, vocational training projects amount is same. I mean, in column 16 lakh 50,000, 16 lakh 15,000. Everyone, moving ahead. So likewise, they have prepared their, you know, and the total amount of contribution consists of 1 crore 95 lakh something. Now, how they will execute? Now, the fourth execution purpose, what if we have discussed, the company can its own, number one. Number two, company can make a foundations of NGO by its own. And third was, as you remember, you can also take the benefit from the independent NGOs, but make sure such NGOs having the 3 years of track record. So here, the first one is through implementing agency. That means they have appointed someone. And such implementing SC has the registration number. Registration number. Project type is one time. That means we are going to discuss very soon the project that will have a timeline of more than 1 year. So just wait, everyone. We will come into this. But before that, we are discussing the annual action plan of the Asian Paints, everyone. Fine. The next plan says, AAP says, we have to mention modalities of utilization fund. See, these are curriculum part, right? If you're thinking that we are discussing very much in details, we are doing classes in ICSI, centralized classes, everyone. So detail is foremost our condition. Moving ahead. So, modalities of utilizations of funds. You have to make a CSR budget. 2% or, you know, at least the amount should be. So, likewise, we have to prepare MOU documents shall state the all set of deliverables from the implementing agencies, everyone. Fine. Project implementation schedules must be there. How you will you know start spending the amount. The all CSR project will be implemented as per the scheduled timeline. and accordingly you have to spend, and make sure you have to spend completely before 31st March of that period. Here the project was 22 project was the for the financial year 22-23. So the word is written before the 31st March 2023. Duration of such project initiative shall be limited up to the same financial year. Right? That means the project has to be completed within the financial year, everyone. Because there are some limitations, you cannot carry forward, right? So moving ahead, monitoring and reporting mechanisms. So how will report? We'll have to read also in the study mat, don't worry. Moving on, project audited, project will be audited. Financial tracking, whether really the amount has been spent or not, how you will check the things that the company has spent the amount. Obviously, we have to check the bank statement, right? Yes or no? Very good. Details of need and impact assessment. See, that's why I'm saying again, it's a different from philanthropy, because here we have to analyze whether in which area we have to perform the CSR activities. So need along with the impact assessment we have to do. That's make a big differences. So as per MCA circular, everyone, a company does not have a CSR obligations of 10 crore or more in the 3 financial year, thereby the impact assessment is not applicable. So what is impact assessment? A kind of check whether your contribution has impacted the society or not. By simply putting a photographs that we have made the building of schools, but in actually the school is not operating. There was no teacher, there was no students, then it's not a not getting any impact to the society, right? So that's why AMSA circular says if your CSR obligation is 10 crore or more, you have to compulsory do the impact assessment, right? So it's a long-term check, everyone. It's a long-term check. Just a second, moving ahead, everyone. So that was the AAP. So AAP consists of what, everyone? AAP consists of the current year plan, right? The modalities of payment, the utilizations of payment, the action that will be taken by the CSR committee, right? Make sure everything is spent, everything must be spent, right? In the same financial year. Impact assessment we have to do. But when it is less than 10 crores, we don't have to follow the impact assessment requirement. So these are the essential points that we must consider. Very, very good, everyone. Moving ahead. So let us discuss again by question answer format. What are the responsibilities of the board in relation to CSR provisions? Now, this is the responsibility of the board, right? Not CSR. CSR is a board-driven process, everyone. CSR itself a board-driven process. Fine. A board-driven process, everyone. CSR. The responsibilities of board of a CSR inter alia include the following. Number one, approve the CSR policy. So the committee will make the policy, and the committee will forward the policy to board, and the board will approve the policy, or the board can change the policy also. So in exam, if you find the questions that saying what are the responsibility of the board, you know what? Board is an ultimate responsibility. So board will approve the CSR. Again, board means what? Board of directors. Disclose content of the such policy in its report and also place it to the company's website. Ensure that the activities included in CSR policies are undertaken by the company. Next, ensure that the company spends in every financial year at least 2% average net profit. Do you know everyone? Now the company will penalize if the company is unable to spend their minimum contribution here. We'll come into this, don't worry. Moving ahead, specify itself regarding the utilization of or distribution of funds. The board of directors has to satisfy itself. Very good. If the company fails to spend 2% of the average profit, the board shall is to specify the reason why it has not spent it, why it has not spent that particular amount. And simply putting a reason will not restrain from the penalty, everyone. There is a penalty we will discuss later on. But here, what we are discussing, everyone, we are discussing the responsibility of the board of directors towards the CSR. So board of directors will approve the CSR policy. Board of directors will disclose the content in a website. CSR policy must be undertaken by by taking care by the board of directors. Ensure the company spends at least 2%. Utilization of proceeds will be checked by them, board of directors. If the company fails to spend, the board of directors has to specify in their report, that is called board report, annual report that we have discussed in the middle chapter, the reason why such amount is not spent yet. And also penalty will be there, we'll discuss later on. Fine. What is the role of government in the approval of implementation of CSR? See, the government has not, the government don't have any rules actually. But the government will, check you as per the returns submitted by you. You know what? There's a return procedure also. If you're doing contribution, you have to file the return as the same. Like when we are discussing about the MGT7 of the company's annual report or something, right? Are you remember everyone? The government has no direct role in the approval, but the government will look into this by checking your returns and something. So these are the provisions. Now, how the government will monitor? See, MCA 21 registry. Government knows everything, right? Whenever you are submitting MGT7, that is the annual return of the companies within 6 days of AGM, now in such form, there's a criteria, there's a a page that we have to fill up, whether CSR obligation is there or not. If yes, what amount have spent by the companies yet? So you have to fill the details and know what. The ministry knows your paid up sales capital. The ministry knows your turnover. The ministry knows your profit because you've submitted the OC4 as well. Are you through with this, everyone? So, by MCA 21 registry, that is online platform of the MCA, the MCA will check all these things. Moving ahead, everyone. So I'll say you to please come into the Institute MAT. Now we have to see the Institute MAT as well for raising our confidence that whether we have covered the things or not, everyone. Let us quickly move into the Institute MAT, everyone. Just a second. So here we have the mat of Institute, everyone. Open it quickly. I'll discuss the topic which is not yet covered, and I'll market the portion which is covered by us in the from the discussion, right? So this is our chapter of CSR. It's also a quite big chapter, don't worry, but we'll handle it. Chapter number 17, everyone. Chapter 17. Fine. Very good. Chalo. Now, meaning of corporate social responsibility, we have done this, right? Corporate social responsibility and corporate governance are inseparable, intertwined, right? Corporate governance, you know, the word corporate governance must be there to achieving the maximum goal of the country. Now, as per United Nations Industrial Development Organization, CSR means it's a management concept whereby companies integrate social and environmental concern in their business operations and interaction with their stakeholders. CSR is generally understood as being the way through which company achieves a balance of economic, environmental and social, you know, imperative. This is a concept of triple bottom line, everyone. This is a concept of triple bottom line. That is, just look into this diagram which I am going to make here. Fine. These three P's, everyone. P, P, P. P1, we can say P2, P3. P1 means we can say profit. P2 means we can say people. And P3 means we can say planet. Right. So if you carefully look the diagram, all the P's are together connecting in these points, right? One second. Oh. Right. So all these P's are connecting, you know, this point. So that is a sustainable development, everyone. So that is a sustainable development. That is a sustainable development. Sustainable development. Very, very good. That is sustainable development. Fine. So the organization must consider these three elements in such a way so that sustainable development can be achieved. That means to say, everyone, we cannot focus only in profits. We even can't focus for the charity always, social activities always. कहां से चैरिटी करोगे जब पैसे ही तुम्हारे पास नहीं है? यस एंड वी कैन नॉट लिव इन आइसोलेशंस बाय नॉट टेकिंग केयर ऑफ द एनवायरमेंट दैट इज प्लैनेट. दैट इज अ सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट कॉन्सेप्ट एज पर ट्रिपल बॉटम लाइन अप्रोच एज पर टीबीएल. राइट, आई एम नॉट गुड एट डायग्राम मेकिंग बट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट वेरी इजली दैट दिस अ डायग्राम स्टफ स्टफ यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर इट वाइल यू नो ड्राफ्टिंग द आंसर इन एग्जाम. यू कैन प्रिपेयर एंड यू विल बी गेटिंग अ गुड मार्क्स. सो इट्स अ टीबीएल अप्रोच है वो. मूविंग अहेड फॉर द नेक्स्ट डिस्कशंस. सो वी डन द टीबीएल. यू ऑल्सो नोटेड द टीबीएल अप्रोच. फाइन. सो हियर द टीबीएल अप्रोच सीज वाई एट द सेम टाइम एड्रेसिंग द एक्सपेक्टेशन ऑफ शेयर होल्डर एंड स्टेक होल्डर. फाइन. मूविंग अहेड. The philosophy is giving back to the society because we are using the society's resources, etc. See, we have done this in the part of introductions, everyone. You may read from here, you will get some confidence. Factor influencing CSR. What are the factors which influence the CSR, everyone? We will discuss later on, don't worry. But first of all, coming to the legislation part, this is the CSR journey, everyone. This is the CSR journey, right? First of all, CSR has, you know, came up with a voluntary guidelines in the year of 2009. Voluntary, that was not mandated at that time, right? Next, United Nations also make some principles regarding this. Next, such voluntary guidelines is again amended, and next will call as a National voluntary guidelines. Few changes has been adopted and it has been changed to this. Moving ahead, SEBI in the year of 2012 makes some compulsion of business responsibility reporting BRR, right, based on National's voluntary guidelines that listed company must perform some obligations. Top 100 listed company in the year of 2012, and such VRR in the year of 2015 made compulsion for top 500 companies for the listed companies, and the same again, everyone. The VRR made compulsion. Just a second. Okay, fine. So the SEBI extended the BRR for reporting 500 companies in the year of 2015, right? Now moving ahead, and then the after 12, the Companies Act, new Companies Act enacted, and the provisions came into the force. There is a high level committee which says that CSR framework required by connecting the stakeholders, and then again second high level committee was there. No, they advocate the CSR provisions again, and like this, you know, the CSR is get, you know, mandated, everyone. Fine. Moving ahead, everyone. So CSR under the Companies Act 13, we have done this. One of the world's largest experiment including concept of CSR by making mandated provisions, everyone. And I just want you to, you know, see these chart also. You know what, when CSR gets, mandatory, that was a mandatory, but the penalty has also imposed, right? Has decriminalized and brought a revolution change in the CSR provisions. Earlier, the penalty has been imposed, then penalty has been eased up due to some government initiative of ease of doing businesses, right? And right now, some penalty has been imposed by the Act itself. Next amendment again took place in the year 2022, right? For some format reporting. Now, applicability, if you talk about applicability, we have done this from our curriculum, from our PPTs. Moving ahead. Criteria, we have done this. Unspent amount, we will discuss it, everyone. If someone is not able to spend, then what will be done, right? So, provided a company having any amount which is unspent account shall constitute a CSR committee and comply with the provision of the content of the sections. We'll discuss, don't worry. Now, the question is whether holding subsidiary, we have covered specific requirement, specific criteria for each and every company. There's a specific criteria, everyone. A holding a subsidiary, those are, holding subsidiaries are different from the, complying the 135 provisions, so we cannot club them. If a company has not come to the period of 3 years, don't worry. If it is only 1 year, so percentage of 2% from that particular year. If it's 2 year, make it average for the 2 year. Illustrations, please practice the illustrations, right? We also done this, everyone. Just spend few times, then you'll able to understand by its own. Now, I'm not going to discuss case studies right away. Moving ahead, the compliances part first. Every company, including foreign company, having net worth this during the immediately preceding financial year. Very good, very well explained. Needs to constitute CSR committee. We have done this. CSR committee बनाने का दरकार कब नहीं होगा? जब 50 लाख से एक्सीड नहीं होगा तब नहीं होगा. Fine. Moving ahead, everyone. Now, the ministry says every company covered under the provisions has to submit a return in form CSR2 to registrar. Yes or no? And onwards, the case may be. So that is a practical requirement. So CSR2 to registry is made compulsion to file, provided that the preceding year shall be filed separately on the issue. That was the initial changes. So it was for that year only. Right, everyone. Now moving ahead. Further, that for financial year 21-22 from CSR shall be separately filed. Okay. That was the initial year. Moving ahead. Test your knowledge, test yourself. Are CSR provision applicable to private or sustained company? We have done this, everyone. Are CSR provision applicable to joint venture company? Yes, we have done this. Company means every company. And specific criteria you have to perform. Question number three, which says 50 lakhs obligations to be checked. If not, then the board itself will do the activities, do the work of CSR committee, not required to make any, separate CSR committee. Important definitions. What is administrative overhead? Administrative overhead means the expenses incurred by the company for general management. See, if the company is going to manage now something for the CSR, the company has to appoint an employee as well for that activities. And that is separate from any project expenses. Okay, just read it. You will get to know this. Administrative of CSR functions in the company, but shall not include but should not include the expenses directly incurred for the designing and implementation and monitoring. So designing implementation monitoring वाला पार्ट यहाँ पे कंप्यूट नहीं होगा, दैट विल बी काउंटेड अंडर द स्पेसिफिक प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ सीएसआर. सी इफ यू आर मेकिंग अ प्रोजेक्ट राइट टू फाइनेंस टू इम्प्लीमेंट, सो सच प्रोजेक्ट हैव सम प्लान एंड डिजाइनिंग इम्प्लीमेंटेशन इट हैज सम चार्जेस राइट. सो दैट पर्पज टोटल कॉस्ट विल कवर दिस डिजाइनिंग चार्जेस एंड ऑल. बट एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ओवरले डिफरेंट थिंग, दैट इज फॉर द मैनेजमेंट पार्ट राइट, फॉर द कॉर्पोरेट सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी फंक्शंस ओवरऑल. सो दैट्स व्हाई डिफरेंशिएटेड हियर राइट. सो व्हाई दे हैव डिफरेंशिएटेड, बिकॉज देर इज अ क्राइटेरिया, यू कैन नॉट स्पेंड मोर देन द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ओवर इट, द लिमिट इज देयर, वी विल डिस्कस शॉर्टली, डोंट वरी. कॉर्पोरेट सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी मीन्स एक्टिविटीज अंडरटेकन बाय द कंपनी इन परस्यूएंस ऑफ स्टैट्यूटरी ऑब्लिगेशन. We have done this. Now, everyone, I want to draw your attention here by my own PPTs. Let's check the PPTs first, then we'll come to this. नहीं थोड़ा कंफ्यूजन हो जाओगे, इसलिए मैं एक बार यहां आना चाहूंगा और आपको दिखाना चाहूंगा. As we discussed, what are the activities which we have to perform if the CSR gets attracted? So these are the criteria. Moving ahead, the following activities are not included in CSR. So there are some exceptions that every activity is not covered under CSR. Now, if you are doing the same activity that you are doing in their normal course of business, so the same activity which you do in normal course of business, it won't be counted as CSR activities, everyone. Oh my God. Activities undertaken outside India, if anything done to outside India, it is again a deemed as not undertaken. CSR projects a program that benefits only employees. If you have made some funds, some arrangements to help your employees, their children, right? That is not a CSR. Right? So only doing this is not a CSR. But you know what? You provide some food facilities. And in such places, your employees went and they also taken the facility. Then it won't be considered. It will be counted as a CSR activities, right? कि तुम्हारा employee भी खा लिया खाना, don't worry. But here, the act says you are making a benefit only for the employees. That is not a CSR activities. Do you know why? Because employee expenses you can deduct from your, profit, right? But CSR expenditure you can't. Come on. Are you through with this, everyone? You may so. I have given such and such facility at the welfare of the employees, and you can, charge against the expenses. Are you through with this, everyone? We are studying like an expert, everyone, right? So your focus should be there because you have to clear these exams, and for this, you have to study in detail as well. You will be getting questions from each and every chapters, right? So for this, you have to study hard and start practicing on a daily basis. Your written practice will make you Surety, or will make assure you that you are going to crack the exam or not. So moving ahead, everyone. So contribution number fourth point, contribution to any amount directly or indirectly to any political party. If you are contributing to any political party under Section 182 of the Act, shall not be considered as CSR activities. Everyone shall not be considered as CSR activity. Activity not covered under Schedule 7, as we said. If you are doing something which is not covered under Schedule 7, it is not a CSR activity. So what we are studying, sir? We are studying here the activity which is not covered, which are not covered. Number one. So number one, what we said, activities undertaking normal course of businesses, not covered. Activity undertaken outside India, not covered. And number next, if the anything is for only employees, it's also not covered. Number four is for contribution to political party is also not covered. An activity covered through seven is also not there. If the activities cover is not there in your plan, then it's also not in activity as per law. Fine. And now you must have no nowadays nowadays you can know very much aware of that, the things that one time events is going on, just like marathons, awards, charitable contributions. This is not a CSR activity. One off events such as marathons, awards, charitable contributions, right, advertisements, sponsorships of TV programs, TV programs sponsorship would not be qualified as a part of CSR expenditure. These kind of things is not a part of CSR expenditure, everyone. Expenses incurred by the companies for the fulfillment of the act. Right? Expenses incurred by the company for the fulfillment of any act statutes such as labor laws and land acquisitions would not be counted as CSR. I'm taking the example, everyone. You are giving bonus to the employee. You are saying, I have given an extra amount of, the money to the employees. So will it be covered under CSR? Let us cover under CSR. The act says no. It's not a CSR activity because you are going to comply as per the respective requirement of bonus, PF, gratuity, and etc. Right? Such labor laws would not constitute CSR activities. Very, very good, everyone. Very, very good. So, next. These are the points, everyone, that is not covered under CSR activities. So now you will able to understand the Institute MAT, you just read it. You just read it, everyone. Here by chart, Institute tried to emphasize the points, contribution to political parties, actors when employees, normal businesses, right? Whether distribution of free samples to customers can be considered as CSR activities? Free samples to customers? No, it's a normal course of business act, right? If someone is, if you are selling some sweets, right, and the customer came to you and he or she asked, can you just, give me some, so that you can test it. It's not a CSR activity. It's a business, normal course of business. The customer may ask and you have to provide. It's a business culture, right? So it's not, it will not be considered as a CSR activities. Moving ahead. Whether the company is organizing preventive health check, health camps, preventive health camps, right? Awareness program. Will it be considered as his activities? Any activities where benefits is exclusively the person who are associated with the business of the company may be considered activity in normal course of business. So if you are making some arrangements for your employees, health checkup camp, right? Your vendors, right? Your customers, that means you are doing your normal course of business, right? But whenever, if you are doing anything for the entire society, and from such activity your employees indirectly gets benefited, that will be covered as a we can say CSR activities. Very good, everyone. CSR committee, CSR policy, done. International organizations like United Nations have ongoing project, everyone. When your activities is not going to complete by a same year, that is called we need to take one, I mean to say, further year. If we take, then we can say ongoing project. So multiple years involved here, right? But not exceeding 3 years. Therefore, maximum 3 years for the ongoing project. Like you are going to make a school, build a school, right? So by building a school, you must know you actually require at least 7 to 8 months for a building, right? Or at least 1 year, we can say. And then you'll publicize that particular things, you'll appoint teacher, you'll also start advertising for the students and all for the free education. Then after some year, 1 or 2 year after, we can able to operate such things. So depending upon the activities now, it will take time, right? So for the one time project, not an issue. You can make a plan up for the single financial year, but for the ongoing project, it will take multiple, I mean, at least 1 or 2 year, or maybe 3 years, but not more than that. For this, we have done, everyone. Moving ahead, ongoing project. Now, multi-year project undertaken by the company in fulfillment of CSR obligations. Ongoing project, everyone. Timeline not exceeding 3 years. Excluding the financial in which it was commenced. Include project that was initially not approved, but whose duration has been extended beyond 1 year. Sometime the board may think of this is the one-time project, but we are not able to complete. So by taking the approval from the board, it can be extended. So that's why the point is written over here, everyone. But normally, one time has to be completed during such financial year. Moving ahead, everyone. So here it is mentioned that one time project, does the term one time, I mean ongoing project, does the term ongoing project means project involving capital assets like building, hospitals, any other infrastructures related CSR project which generally takes more than a year to complete? Yes, ongoing project has defined these rules so as to mean a multiple year project undertaken by the company in the fulfillment of CSR obligations, having timelines not exceeding 3 years, excluding the financial year in which it was commenced. Right, so whenever you are starting, say for example, you're starting this today, 7th February 2024. If you're starting from today, then the period of 3 years will be counted from 24-25, because this 23-24 will be excluded while calculating 3 years. It is mentioned here, everyone. So how we'll calculate 3 years, excluding the financial year in which it was commenced, and shall include such product that was initially not approved multiple year, but whose duration has been extended beyond 1 year. So how will start counting 3 years by this provisions, and also includes some project which earlier was to have been for 1 year, now it is extended due to some circumstances, right? Such ongoing project may or may not involve capital assets, development of any other infrastructures. It is not compulsion that if you are making some assets, then we will get the ongoing projects approval. That is not in conditions, right? But people actually, if wish to do these activities, they require a extra time. Fine, everyone. Great. So I'm just taking again a 5 minutes break. Please come back after 5 minutes. So moving ahead, everyone. For our next discussion, sure. So we have done this. CSR committee, again, we completed this, how we can formulate the committees, and this is the, criteria. Can a group of 15 companies constitute a single CSR committee? No, the committee is for the separate company, everyone. Okay. Hence, every company fulfilling the criteria laid down in 135 should constitute a CSR committee for itself. Are you through with this, everyone? Very, very good. Very, very good, everyone. Let's moving ahead. This function of CSR committee, we have done this. To formulate policies and all. Right. Meeting of CSR committee. Now, CSR committee have to, meet, right? We will discuss the meeting chapter of board of directors and the committees in a separate chapter, everyone. But just because in this particular chapter, we have to discuss number of CSR committee, everyone. The law says, law is silent, the number of CSR committee meeting in a year, but as per secretary standard one, right? So what is secretary standard, sir? We have, sir, so we already seen, sir, the SS2. So what is SS1? You may have questions, right? So let me clarify all of you. SS2 was for the general meeting standards. And SS1 is for the board meeting and committee meeting. SS1 is for board meeting and committee meeting, everyone. So you have to follow the SS1 also. Act is silent. So whenever act is not specified anything, the Company Secretary Institute, the ICSI, try to, make some laws on their part, and it has done with the SS1. Shall meet often and necessary subjects to minimum number of frequencies stipulated by the Board of Directors. Fine, everyone. Now, quorum. If there is a meeting, the quorum requirement will also be there, right? Law is again silent with respect to quorum because law itself not saying anything about the meeting of the CSR committee. But meeting should be held, right? So that the discussion will be, happen. What was the purpose? What amount has been expended so far? What is the current requirement, right? What is the status of monitoring? What is the status of the project? So, so meeting must be there, right? So SS1 says, and the company has to follow SS1, everyone. The presence of all the members of any committee constituted by the board is necessary to form a quorum. So presence of all the members of the any committee. So normally we have three person in a listed company, public company, two if no ID. So in that different requirements, all the members must be there. If it's a public company, listed public company, at least three person, I mean all the three person we can say, will be there. The presence of all the meetings of any committee constituted by the board is necessary to form the quorum, unless otherwise stipulated in the act or any law or your article as well. So if article provides anything special, then you have to follow as per the article, not an issue. So moving ahead, everyone. A member of committee appointed board elected committee's chairman shall conduct the meeting of the committee. As simple as that. Fine. Moving ahead. Functions and responsibility of the board. We have done this, everyone. You may read from here. Moving ahead. Next is CSR implementations. CSR implementations. The board shall ensure that CSR activities are undertaken by the company itself or through other established Section 8 company. Make sure everyone, such Section 8 company have registered. Under 80G of the Income Tax Act and also 12A of the Income Tax Act, everyone. Right? Established track record must be there. Yes. These are the criteria for the similar activities if you are going to take the help of any other independent organization. Moving ahead, will the company become non-compliant? Yes, non-compliant. If you are taking or doing anything with the help of agencies, that is implementing agencies, and such implementing agencies not registered with the Income Tax Act as per Section 12A and the 80G, then it will not be a valid implementing agency, everyone. But you know, before compulsion of such implementing agency, if before completion of such implementing agency, if anything has been already in a process, then law says during such compulsion you may register yourself. But from the 22nd January 2021, if you are taking any project or you as a company giving the project to any implementing agency, make sure such implementing agency has already taken the registration as per 12A and 80G of the Income Tax Act. You must have remember 80G, everyone, where the Income Tax Act says if someone is contributing to such things, they will get deductions 50%, 100%. I hope you are remembering these things. Moving ahead, everyone. Mandatory registrations of the CSR entity. Mandatory registration of CSR entity. As per CSR1 electronically format, which is made effective from 1st April 2021. So it is compulsory now to have get registered. Certificate of professional. Moving ahead. Now, CSR shall be signed by the submitted electronic form by the entities, those who want to, you know, do some activities, CSR activities, that is called CSR entity, self-verified digitally through chartered accountant practice, company secretary practice, and so this is a certification requirement by the professionals. On the submission of CSR1 on the portal, a unique CSR registration number shall be generated by the system automatically. So once being an implementing agency, if you are registering with the MCA, right? So there's a requirement of IA. IA has to do everyone. IA को क्या करना पड़ता है भाई? IT Act में भी रजिस्ट्रेशन लेना पड़ेगा. IT Act, रजिस्ट्रेशन has to be taken in the IT Act, everyone. And CSR1 also with the MCA, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, right? Then you can do the activity of other company. Very good. Moving ahead. Now, a company carries out a CSR project. A company carries out a CSR project out of its CSR project acts through an implementing agency during 2021. During 2021. During 2021. Fine. Company A intends to start a new CSR project. Why? Right? In the year 2021. The implementing agency will have to register itself for Project Y filing CSR1 because implementing agency's registration requirements effective from 22nd January 2021, राइट right? सो पुराने वाले के लिए गम नहीं है, बट नए वाले के लिए रजिस्ट्रेशन लेना इज कंपल्सरी. सो एज प्रोजेक्ट एक्स इज ऑन गोइंग प्रोजेक्ट, द इम्प्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू फाइल CSR1. आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेरी वेरी गुड, अ बिट टेक्निकल बट यू नो वेरी मच इंटरेस्टिंग, राइट. CSR in a worldwide, going to be a, hot topic. CSR, there is a SDG requirement, everyone. SDG, the global requirement, social development growth requirement, everyone. Social development plan is going on throughout the world, everyone. And by taking such wordings, the government of India has also enacted this Schedule 7 activities. Right. Moving ahead, everyone. Role of international organizations. We cannot appoint any international organization as our implementing agency. We will not. Yes, we can take the help for the monitoring and evaluation of the CSR project, but we can't give them for CSR activities. Can a company collaborate with the other company? It is allowed, not an issue. Company can collaborate with the other company for the CSR activities. Very, very good. CFO certifications, everyone. Now, there's a requirement that for the fund distributions, CFO is responsible for the financial things, right? So, for the funds distribution, CFO has to give certificate, right? So that is why the MAT is cover the topic of CSR certifications. I'm just marking the important lines so that you must not miss this particular things. Test yourself at the frequency. What frequency, in what frequency CSR certification is required? Act has not prescribed any frequencies, right? It may be separately for the each project, each activities. Whether CFO should certify the board after the disbursing the amount implementing? No. Dispersal certificate is not required here. The act only says CFO certificates for funds that has been disbursed for the company by the company. Right. So answer is no. After disbursing amount to implementing agency, he is not required to certify whether the implementing agency has utilized or not. That is not a concern. That will be concerned by the CSR committee or the board of directors. That is called under monitoring evolutions, we can say. Question: if a company spends only by way of contribution to PM relief fund or PM care fund, in such a case, board would have only approved contribution to the PM relief fund and no other projects. Hence, CFO only needs to certify that funds have been contributed to these funds. So, disbursals ke liye we have to give the certificate, but once we have contributed to implementing agencies, so everything will be done by the monitoring activities. Fine, moving in. Ongoing project. Who will monitor such ongoing projected one? The board of a company shall monitor the implementation of the project. Right? Year-wise allocations must be there, shall be competent to make modifications, etc., etc. Now, how to identify appropriate implementing agency? You may write a questions. How to identify the appropriate implementing agency, everyone? How to identify? These are the criteria to identify the appropriate implementing agency. So we must keep in mind the following points. Such agency is having the 3 years of track records, everyone. Such having the 3 years of no track record. The implementing ANC should not have any association with any political party. Right? Directly or indirectly. An implementing ANC should not have any conflict of interest with the employees of the company. Not conflict of interest. ऐसा नहीं हो पैसा दी कंट्रीब्यूट करके और इनडायरेक्टली पैसा एम्प्लॉयज के पॉकेट में. नो, ऐसा नहीं होगा. द इम्प्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी शुड हैव रजिस्ट्रेशन. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, राइट? द एंसिडेंस ऑफ द इम्प्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसीज पास्ट रेपुटेशन, द रेपुटेशन ऑफ पर्सन एसोसिएटेड विद देम, एवरीथिंग शुड बी स्क्रूटनाइज बिफोर सिलेक्शंस. यू नो, so whenever you are selecting your implementing agency for the CSR activities, make sure you should consider these following points. Number one, it has a track record of 3 years or more. Number two, at least you know this is not associated with any political party directly or indirectly. Number next, it should not involve any interest with the employees concerned. And it must get registration first before entering into this under Income Tax Act, Section 12A and G, and make sure the track record, reputations, and employees good work this particular agency. Moving ahead, any other requirement which the central governments or authority prescribe, we have to follow such requirement also. I hope it is clear to all of you. Moving ahead, CSR policy, we have done the policy part, right? Annual action plan, everyone. I have already, shown you the, app of Asian Paint and what are the content of app we have already done, but quickly we will go through this by the our institute man. Moving ahead. CSR policy done? Fine. Approach and direction of CSR is to be recommended by the CSR committee. The CSR policy is to be prepared and recommended by the CSR committee report. As per Section 135(3) of the Act, the CSR policy shall indicate the activities to be taken by the company. Done. And it's compulsion. Fine. For example, you just read it. The company must focus on the local area first. That is the area in which the companies exist, everyone. Right? And must abide by the general principle of the implementing agencies, guiding principle of monitoring policies, and all. General principles for formulating annual action plan can be whether long-term plan or short-term plan. Make sure these are the basically a part. Now, CSR policy should be approved by the board. We have done this. Should be approved by the board, right? And recommended by the committee, approved by the board. Recommended by the committee, approved by the board. Outline a CSR policy to reflect a vision, mission, and goal of broader label. Right. CSR policy should articulate broadly target group, geographically, locally, and wider sense you have to cover. Moving ahead, everyone, test your knowledge. Can a company spend in project or program related to activities mentioned in Rule 7, but not specifically covered in the policies? Says the board shall ensure the company spend at least two. Right? If a company wishes to spend funds on the activities but not specifically covered CSR policy, it may do so by the suitably amending the CSR policy with the approval of central board. Sorry. So if the law says now, you have to focus on your CSR policy because you have made the policy as per Rule 7. Now, in your CSR policy, you have covered eradicating hunger or Olympic and all, we have covered, right? But again, by utilizing such amount, you feel that I have some other purpose also, which is again as per the Civil 7. But we have to further take approval from the board that in the meanwhile we are changing our objects. You can take the approval and you can start contributing, not an issue. Are you through with this, everyone? Very, very good. Moving ahead, is it mandatory to amend a CSR policy after the amendments? If existing policy covers following items, CSR policy need not to be amended. What are the items? It is the a content, approach and directions approved by the board, guiding principles, selection of CSR project, implementation of project, monitoring of CSR project. These are the content of the policy, everyone. If you have mentioned these content and the conduct, then you need not to amend the policy. Monitoring formulations of APAP. Moving ahead. What is annual action plan? We have done this with the help of Asian Paints. Moving ahead, everyone. The list of CSR project. Yes. Can you remember this, everyone? The manner of executions. Who will implement, your own or implementing agencies? And how the fund will be distributed, in what tranches? Maybe mention monitoring and reporting of mechanism for the projects or program. Yes, details need an impact assessment. We have done this. That makes the difference from philanthropy, I said you. Now, if it is further provided, the board may alter such plan at any time during the financial year. As per the recommendation of CSR committee, though the plan can also be changed. One second. So, accordingly, in the given cases, CSR projects should be completed and amount of money left unutilized be considered by the board for spending for other CSR project during the year can be allowed, not an issue. All CSR project activities are required to approve by in annual action plan. Right, everyone? Fine. The app shall change for each financial year. So separate app for each financial year as we discuss as per the Asian Paint app plan that was for 22-23. So each financial year has a separate app. I mean to say annual action plan. Very, very good, everyone. Now moving ahead, as it is manifestations of the guiding principles we have to follow. Now, here we have some examples, everyone. For example, list of programs or list of broad categories, criteria, we've done this. Manner of executions, how we'll execute, one time or not. Models of funds, monitoring and mechanisms, fixation, who shall do impact assessment, which project, timeline, etc. Everything should be there, everyone. You may learn the content. Right? Moving ahead. Now, what is this Schedule 7? We have done this, everyone. You must go through as per ICSM Act as well. Right? For the detailed discussions or detailed study. So, Schedule 7 in detail, pure as per the law mentioned here, everyone. So, 7 eradicating hungers, poverty, malnutrition, promoting educations, promoting gender equality, ensuring environmental sustainability, right? Protection of national heritages, etc., etc., etc. You have to, as I said, contribution to the public funded universities, IITs is also there. Right, ICMR, IRDO, DDRO, sorry, DAE, Department of Atomic Energy. So this is cover here, all right? Rural development, etc., etc. Here, one-time event will not be the part. How has the season spending pertaining to COVID-19 been inculcated in the Companies Act? I told you, na. in the time of COVID-19, the Schedule 7 has been changed, right, and PM CARE funds also, made very famous. MC clarifications upon this. MC clarified that spending CSR funds for carrying out awareness campaigns for public outreach campaigns on COVID-19 is an eligible CSR activity, item 1, 2, and 7th of, I mean 12th of Schedule 7. So item 1, 2 ke andar that will be considered as. What was item 2? Let's check it out. Item 1 and 2. Swachh Bharat, that is Safai, Saf Abhiyan. 1, 2, educating them for the COVID-19. And 12th is Disaster Management Act. You know what? Whenever any kind of pandemic is, happen now, the Disaster Management Act gets applicable. So for the disaster management, we can contribute. Very, very good, everyone. Clarification of spending on CSR funds. Makeshift hospitals and temporary COVID care. During that time, it is covered, right? Because of promoting health care is a 1 and 12 ka point, right? So likewise, COVID care also covered here, everyone. So please read it out. Moving ahead, how should the list provided in Schedule 7 of the Companies Act be construed for the purpose of undertaking CSR activity? How should the list provided in Schedule 7? The statutory provision of CSR rules 2014 are to ensure that activities undertaken in personal CSR policy. So activity will be undertaken as per the CSR policy, everyone, right? So CSR policy will be the first to understand, right? So please read it. So let us quickly revise whatever we have discussed for the today's class, everyone. Just a second. Let me show you the PPTs again. Fine. So for today's class, we have first discussed this one, Schedule 7, the activities, the name of the activities, and their importance. You cannot do anything beyond these CSR activities. There is nothing is covered here. Your contribution will not be treated as a CSR contribution. Moving ahead, everyone. And Schedule 7 also includes PM another fund, right? PM Care Fund also. Next, moving ahead, everyone. These are not considered as a CSR activities. If you're doing normal course of business, activity undertaken outside India, only the employees gets benefited, right? Yeah, if you're doing something for any political party or any person who's connected to political party, right? Activities are not covered. Rule 7 is also excluded. One time event, marathon, are not covered. Expenses of for particular or compliance of particular act is not a CSR activity. We have done this. Now here the applicability criteria, everyone: turnover, net worth, and net profit. So these are the criteria. If the figures gets triggered, then you have to follow two things. Number one, making a committee of CSR out of the board members, right? And number two, contributing of at least 2% for the previous last three financial year, average 3% profit. Moving ahead. Okay, next. These are the constitution's framework for the CSR committee. Public company having ID, three, one shall be ID, and not ID in a public company, then two. Listed company have the same criteria of the public company having ID. Private company, two directors. Foreign company also two directors, but make sure 381D ka hi person hona chahiye. Very good. And apart from this, we again We tried to solve some question answer, right? So just a second, everyone. I'm just drawing your attention to the question answer series. Yes. Yes. So, these are question answer series. Let us discuss it one by one. So we have done the applicability questions, right? Yes, a subsidiary holding, separate things. Every means every company. Yes, agar bane mein 2 saal hua hai, 2 saal ke liye kar lo. Right, if you are from 2 years, then average 2 years will be there, will be considered. CSR framework done, committees done. Next, yes, who will take care? CSR committee will take care of everything, but ultimate approval lies with the board, right? Everyone, board is also approving the CSR policy along with the content and everything, everyone, and also will take part in the monitoring process, right? So, we have done these kind of questions, right, everyone. So I guess you much be able to understand today's topic. So we have some few topics remains in the CSR curriculum, and we'll try to finish by tomorrow first part, and then we'll again, if possible, we'll start the next chapter. For today, everyone, that's it. Keep learning and keep growing. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Take care, everyone.